Hi all, I'm Jamie Dahl with Central State University and I'm here with
Dave Apsley and I'm with OSU Extension. And today we're going to do a little review on the basics of tree ID. So for the first slide, we're pretty excited. We worked collaboratively with Division of Wildlife and Division of Forestry to help put together this new tree ID guide. So we're excited that it's out there and available through Division of Wildlife. Just another shot of the back of that cover of that new publication. And then this is a publication that we use quite often to just review some of the basics and teach some of the basics of tree ID. It's a bulletin that we've produced through Ohio State University Extension. So what I first want to do is review a little bit about leaf arrangement, and that's how the leaves are attached to the twig, that's where the buds are, and then it also is determines the branching down the road. So this is again another example of what's in the book. Today we're going to focus in on the trees that are opposite, and by opposite we mean the one in the middle. The leaves are paired up on one side of the twig. You're going to have a bud and a leaf, and then you'll have the same thing on the opposite side, so they're kind of paired up. And then we'll contrast that a little bit with those that are alternate, which is the most common type of tree that we're going to see out there. We'll get a little bit into leaf shapes, and then we'll talk a little bit about the types of leaves that are out there. But really, when it comes to the opposite leaf arrangement, you got to remember the mad buck. For those of us that work for and are Buckeye fans, mad buck is a great way to remember the trees that have paired or opposite leaf arrangement are the maples, the ash, the dogwoods, and the buckeyes.